mission of the Minnesota Historical Society is to use the power of history to transform lives. That means documenting history, cultures, movements, people from all walks that make Minnesota, Minnesota. So when state archivists recently stumbled upon a box of makeshift prison weapons, tools, and art in Minnesota's oldest prison, they thought, we should preserve this, because it has a story. When it comes to prisons, these are items rarely let out. When it comes to museums, these are words rarely spoken.
I don't get to handle shanks every day.
Sandra Ryerson has been tasked with archiving the weapons, tools, and art confiscated from inmates inside the Stillwater State Prison.
As a museum curator, do you find it strange to use words like shiv, shank, and nunchuck?
I think it's really fun. These pieces are certainly unique.
Something dark about what you just said.
In March, state archivists were searching the Stillwater vault for records when they found a box stuffed with contraband.
These pieces speak to a specific experience, and we're in the business of trying to document, trying to represent all of Minnesotans' experiences.
Collected from the 1970s to the 1990s, we see tools MacGyver would be proud of.
These are homemade tattoo guns from two different decades. You have a built-in power source.
Yep.
You stabilize it with a toothbrush, run your guitar string through the body of a pen so that you can keep things going straight. And turn it on, you're good to go.
There are also tools like a drug scale, false bottom drug mug, and hacksaw that MacGyver would not be proud of.
Somebody grabbed a couple of blades, they even packed themselves an extra, and they were trying to get that back into the cell block, presumably to break out of their cell.
And then there are the weapons. It's a sobering view of the violent and inventive environment of high security prison.
A shard of metal from the metal shop, wrapped in masking tape to create a handle.
Knives.
If you look closely at this, you'll see that this is just a metal ruler.
Bludgeons.
It's just melted weld beads into a bludgeon and then wrapped in a fabric tape. You'd swing this and take somebody out with it.
Nunchucks.
Pretty professionally done, I have to say. I mean, well knotted, I mean, well drilled, well finished.
Somewhere an inmate saying, thank you, Sandra. Yeah.
And one huge machete.
What guard was on duty? Like when that was fabricated?
Yeah, that's an excellent question. And this was used in an escape knife with the date 1922.
What people can make in dire circumstances with virtually no tools is astonishing. Perhaps the most is the art.
This is a white-tailed deer made of toilet paper.
You heard correctly. This 14-pointer is 100% toilet paper. Another inmate used nails, not for a weapon, but a pin pillow.
It's just got this gorgeous design inside.
How these items were used and the stories behind them are unclear. But what is remarkable and scary is what necessity can create.
Wow. It was kind of astonishing to see all that stuff. You always see it in movies and TV shows. You read about it maybe, but, you know, that's real life. This stuff happens, and in this case, art imitates life. Also, yeah, it's not available for the public to see. It's not on display there. It's going to be on a digital.
How'd you get in?
Because I'm a reporter. I have no idea. They invited us out to see it. But it's going to be on digital archive in December. So as the public, you'll be able to see all of those items and much more digitally. It's in the basements. It's in a locked, humidity-controlled archive.
Very cool.
The toilet paper thing just really threw me.
100% toilet paper. Unbelievable. It's like Escape from Alcatraz. They use paper mache, and you never know what you can do.
The human mind is something else.
Necessity.
Time and
Mother
pressure.
Time and pressure, I get. All right. Well, before we get to the next round of ads, we want to share some of the thoughts you gave us about Kathy Griffin. And you had him.
Oh,
sure had him.